What's going on, guys? Welcome back to Bronze Escape. Now, this one we are having a little bit of fun with because I am the support and we're using Galio, which is like reworked Galio, and it's the first time of using him with the rework. I used him prior to the rework and he was really good as a support. And I've looked at his abilities, I've looked at what he can do, I've looked at what they've upgraded, how they've made him look. He's absolutely looks amazing. One of the skins I saw for him just looks absolutely amazing, and I'll try and get hold of it. Depending whether I like the actual character play, and I think I do, because like I say, I've never played the reworked one. This is the first time, but I'm bringing it in ranked as well. Something you shouldn't really do, but you know, it's not hard just to build him tank, and you can get used to a character quite quickly. Or I can. So basically, we're jumping straight into it. What we're gonna do is we're going to take, where is it? It's that one.
I bet it's great though.
Right.
The world. It goes by in a flash.
This is gonna be really fun. Like, who's our jungle? Jax is the jungle. Again, like, I like the whole rework idea they've done, everything they've done with him. If you read some of the abilities, like Justice Punch, Galio lunges forward with a mighty blow, dealing damage to enemies and knocking them into the air, so he's going to work quite well with that. What's this? First cast, Galio starts to charge. Second cast, Galio taunts nearby enemies. Well, that's not too bad. And Galio fires two wind blasts. Fair enough. So, I think.
At last, a change of scenery.
Minions have spawned.
Aren't we kind of wonderful? Wow.
Feels good to stretch my wings.
Why would he do that? Like I say, I think we're going to go with the Q because of the blast and then the damage. But, wow, no. Just no.
It's not easy when everyone looks up to you.
Right, I don't know what Jin is doing. Seriously, Twitch is gone there, and then he's gonna go there, and then there.
I fought a house once. I'm pretty sure I won.
Lucian having first blood. Not really helping. It's good. It's to work out quite well for me. They've got 4 kills already. That worked out well. Galio's actually looking quite deadly, to be honest with you. Seriously. Nice try though, Leona. Very nice try.
I'm a big man.
This Galio is definitely someone to be reckoned with. But if Jax would have been smarter, we would have had Leo. Oh, not a great start to my team, to be honest with you. Jax, 2 deaths. instantly, because the first time, or the first one, was him being like, for me, it was a stupid move to do, but he did it. So yeah, I'm not gonna say it's him being stupid. It was just something he should have. Warding up, great. Go ward up, do that. In fact, yeah. Right, yeah, go ward up, do that. But don't stay around to try and get a couple of hits on the jungle. Get out of there. You've warded up, you've done a great thing, and you got out of there and you can go get your buffs. That's not too bad. But their Rumble having two kills is not going to be good. Lucian having a kill to start off with is not good. Leona got the kill on Jin, which again is not too bad. But I think this Galio is going to be really something to look for. Have that, yeah. This Galio, deadly. Very deadly. Crook. No! Oh, swear this changed. This is back and forth. I'm liking this. Didn't expect the Twitch down there. Right, we're definitely going to throw up this. A lot of back and forth with this, but this Galio is very, very deadly. Jax got a kill, which is good. Is that two for Jax? Yeah, it's two for Jax. Hopefully, if we can get a couple more for Jax, we're doing fine. But yeah, this Galio is insane. I can really get used to this character, especially as a support as well, because the way you can just jump in, crack, boom. This W I have to get used to. So I cast it, it starts to charge, gaining 20 damage from boost, slowing himself. So it's just, is it like a bubble? Or a bubble charging thing? Or I don't know how that one works. That's interesting. I'm definitely going to try and get used to it, but this Galio is definitely going to work as support. His ultimate is something I'm going to be really looking forward to. Just play it careful, because I don't want to go too far out. Oh my god, it's on my shoulder.
It's completely unfair. I didn't ask to be this impressive.
Keep crawling out some pulse, as we do. I reckon we're doing just that smidgey's better.
I don't breathe.
Mate, Jin, you need to back out. Whew. This is back and forth, but Jin, I think we did him quite well. I think it's not a bad idea to go back. To be honest with you, it's not a bad idea. I want to read this as well. Designates an ally champion's current position at his landing spot and grants 20 damage reduction to an ally until he lands. Right, so
I like buying personally.
That's actually quite fun.
I don't know what this is, I bet it's great, though.
When Galio lands, enemies in the area take damage and they're knocked into the air. So this Galio rework for me would work so much with Yasuo, because if he doesn't get his ultimate off smashed with the E, then you can just like fly to him with the R, and then when you land, boom, done. This Galio is going to be working quite well for a lot of them. Oh, there it is. Did he just use her ultimate on me? My ward will stay better. She did just use her ultimate on me. Jax could possibly be down here quite well.
It sounds like thunder.
So what do I do? Like click my R button onto the champion or something like that? What do I do? I don't want to do my ultimate just yet.
I've seen much. Not sure I understand it, but it happened.
Wow! Seriously? No Jhin, no Fiora, and all five of them down for the Drake. Wow, no help. Wow, no help, good job. That is literally all it is. Jhin's on the lane farm, Fiora's coming down. They were making play for Drake. We tried to counter, but no help. There's literally everything you can put to him. Like, five of them come, and we get none. They was making the play for the Drake. The best thing to do there was to help, but none of them wanted to help. This Jax is in some way poor because he doesn't want to come down to the bottom lane. He wants the bottom lane to stay dead. There you go! My health is dying. I really need some more. To be honest with you, this one can go in here. Oh wow, I need some more armor. I think that's what I need. Took a while, but we actually got there. To the point where it was working quite well, that push. I like that one. Now I want to try this ultimate. I'm thinking I don't know who to use it on.
They just don't make doorways big enough.
I really don't know how to use this ultimate. It's like, do I put it, use it on Diana, or... I'm pretty sure I click the champion. Designate to an allied champion. So yeah, pretty much, you know, you click the champion that's going. Whatnot. So, let's... I was... I get? That almost worked out quite well, actually. Diana, you know, there's like a turret there that you can't get towards. And she's just playing on the tower. You can't play. Wow. I can't play against noobs. That's a quality one. I can't play against noobs. Then what's that make you? Either way, I'm enjoying this Galio and I reckon I can get some decent stuff done with Galio. Seriously, Jin, do you have any damage? Really? Wow, you're why build the Black Cleaver straight away? He needs a lot more damage than he's got. I mean, a butt-ton more damage. Because, I'm going to wait for 20 gold, but like, I'm just saying he needs more damage, but to be honest with you, his first item, right, and this is like most first items, AD carries usually gold, a majority of AD carries that I've seen, pretty much most of them I've seen, they usually go with the BSR to go into either a Bloodthirster or an Infinity Edge. Now, doing that is not a bad idea because you get a lot more damage. Going with a Black Cleaver, again, not criticizing it because I don't know what a Jin works well with. I'm just saying, for me, I wouldn't go Black Cleaver straight away. Fiora's a bit dumb. Literally running on them. Not dying. If I dive, go with me. No, because you're not a tank. If you dive, you're dumb to die. You dived under a tank. Tank? You dived under a tower and you're not tank. Wow, and yeah, again, no Jin to help. Leona's not a tank. She's really not. Not Leona, sorry. Leona is a tank. Fiora is not a tank. Jin's not in the battle with us. This is how it's going. And it's not going very well. Not going well at all. That was a waste of an ultimate, to be honest with you. That was a real waste of my ultimate. Yep. Twitch has gone invisible. We need to push that. We need to push the tower. We really do. Let's see. I don't know what Fiora's doing. Excuse me. Jax is running away. Diana's running away. Fiora's up top. I don't know where Jin is. I don't know what this Jin's doing. I really don't. He needs to be buying more damage. He's got a finished cleaver. Probably about it. Yep. I ain't going into that. Not a chance. Nope. No, ain't dying today. Not dying today. I said don't fight. You also said you can't play against noobs, which makes you worse.
Somehow I always end up in the center of everything.
Nope. We don't take a loss. With a name like Fanks, LOL, you know something's gonna go down. And don't get me wrong, certain parts of this, I probably could have played better or done better, but I don't really understand what I'm doing with a Galio fully. Like, I don't know how the Q works. I think it's because they are too easy. Like, how does that make sense? I can't play against noobs because they are too easy like you, yet you're the one doing 5, 7 and 6. Just saying. No. She's saying she can't play against noobs. I think she's got it mixed up. And this is where a little bit of things can happen because I think it's like barrier of English. Yep, doing that. And everyone just lets that Ackley go. I mean, I put myself in danger there running, but I tried to jump over, Ackley come back for me. It's like, seriously? Wow. This is one thing that I usually don't like to do, but report Fiora for fleeing. People at flame usually, right? And this is why I don't usually get mixed up into all that stuff, is because usually I do slash mute all, and I forgot to do it. Absolutely forgot to do it, and usually I don't forget to do it. So, do you know what? Slash mute all. I usually do that, and that way I can focus on my game and what's going on. But wow, yeah.
Which way's the fight?
Yep, that worked out well. Twitch gets a triple kill. That's nice. Quadra kill. Well played. Well played, Quadra. See, I know I played. I made mistakes in this game. I know I have. Not happening. Don't surrender in this. I don't surrender ranked. Whether I'm losing or not, I've made mistakes and I still won't surrender. I really made mistakes. So I know some parts of this is my fault, but a lot of this is not my fault. I've got like 11 assists, which isn't too bad. Their Leona's not too bad. Oh, it's a lot better than me for the assisted. Jhin, to be honest with you, really doesn't have any damage. And that's the part where I think he's gone a bit wrong on. Because he went, in my eyes, right, and this is only my opinion, I don't know all the other stuff, but he seems to have gone for the wrong type of build. does. Wow. See, this is the thing though, it's like, is this Twitch is getting all these kills because he's being left, like, we're being left with, I jumped in to save the Fiora. Then you've got the Jax and you've got the Jhin that never actually came with us. I mean, yeah, obviously I jumped in too far, so it was hard for them to get to, like, get where I was that quick. But they could, the amount of time it took them to get here, it took Diana quicker. And she was in the same place because we're too busy farming. And that's the problem with most things that I can see. Is that I can't do more if my team's doing nothing but farming. Like, most of the time I'm playing this game, everyone's just farm happy. And I realize farm's good in a lot of ways, but it can also screw you over in other ways. Especially if you don't have teamwork as well. The one thing a lot of people don't realize, and some of the times I can see that I do the same thing, but most of the time when you're playing in a game, a lot of them turn around and say, well, there's no teamwork, there's no this, there's no that. Some of them could literally be on TS or on Skype or on Discord or on stuff like that. They could be on that stuff. So like I say, you could be on that type of thing here, but you also have to look at it is the level of teamwork's not going to be great. It's not going to be to the way that people want, because a lot of people don't work together for the sheer fact is they don't want to. You know, it's just they don't want to work together, they want to do their own thing. And you get a lot of that, like having the hero thing. A lot of people want the hero effect. I think that's killing them, that was amazing. Took his time to do the damage. That's the thing with his Jhin. Takes his time to do the damage. How's that? Nah, we're not got it. We almost got it there though. Right, so I'm gonna get that. It, like the hero effect for me is I don't want to be doing or playing a game where people are just going, well, I can do it all on me because I'm the hero of the game. I will carry the game. I can't carry a game on my own. I've seen people do it. They're really skilled people. But it can't be done in bronze. And that's what too many people are trying to do. I know I'm a bronze league at the minute, but I know that I'm a gold league player. I've proved that to myself, and literally that's all I need to do. As long as I can prove to myself what league I'm in. This just makes for a fun thing of, I can come on, I can do a video, I can record the video, and I can make it a decent video as to me, as opposed to being crap. But doing stuff like this is actually quite fun for me, because I'm trying to escape the bronze. This account, like, I got this account, this was my very first account created. Basically what happened was, when I created the account, I didn't know, like, what was starting, like, the beginning stuff of everything. I didn't know how to play LOL properly. You know, you're like a typical beginner, you don't get used to the game, you just rush into what you're doing. But I didn't just rush in. My friend played it, and he had an account that was in bronze, and it was one of them that we both just, I didn't know he was bronze, he did, and we just sort of, he rushed in to putting me in rank with him, which again didn't bother me because now it gives me an objective to do. I've got an objective to go and make sure that I can get this out of bronze, and that's what gives me that objective, is the fact that I could do that. Can I reach them from there? No. She's just diving for the fun. Yeah, she's just diving for the fun of diving. She's now feeding, that's literally what she's doing. Out quite well for us. Yeah, you can do that. I'm going back. But yeah, like I say, what I can do, let's do that. I say I'm this account was like thrown into bronze unexpectedly. Like I didn't know it was there, and that's how it came along. And don't get me wrong, I'm not complaining about stuff like that, I'm really not. It doesn't bother me if it's a bronze account, because I'm having fun playing in the bronze league and seeing if I can escape. Now, getting coming along cross plays like this, I constantly want to surrender in a bronze. This Fiora is the worst type of player. You come across her, if you don't even have to be in the bronze league, sorry, to come across these type of plays. You could be in gold, you could be in a challenger, you could be stuff like that. It don't have to be the bronze league for these type of plays, it really don't. Because I've seen it, like, because I watch a lot of YouTube videos because I want to improve as a player. No, who doesn't? So when it comes down to watching stuff, when you're watching a challenger and they've got high flamers, you can understand that they're going to be 10 times better than bronze player and still flaming the same way a bronze does, but they do play differently. Because the way that we do play is going to be completely different. I've accepted that I'm around bronze, silver and gold level. I'm around the gold level, but it seems to be at the minute I'm just staying around the bronze area, because I like to do with the teamwork stuff. So I like being stay there. Right, Fiora dropped him. Nice. I did try out. I really did. So yeah, like I say, I like to be around the bronze area of things. I prefer to be the gold, and that's what I'm aiming for. So my objective is to get the account into gold. Even if it takes me a couple of years, I will do it, because you always learn. Every single time you are learning, and that's the main thing you have to understand about LoL, is every time, no matter what, you are learning. Every game you play, you learn, and that's what I'm doing. And I'm learning to try and be better for me. Not for anyone else, but for me. So yeah, that's how it's going to go. And it's just one of them things. You have to accept it. You really do. And I've accepted that at the minute, this account is bronze, but it will eventually be gold. And if it's gold 5, sweet. I'll aim for a bigger objective after that. But that's literally what I have to try and do. It's what I've got to do. This isn't going to end very well for everyone, because they're not doing much in the order of... Screw you then. Seriously, Fiora, don't follow. Don't follow. Oh my god, did no one understand the don't follow? Because, oh yeah, she's just going into dive. Wow. Yeah, she's just feeding now. Because none of us are quitting, she's feeding. I don't mind taking up a kill. I know, I'm not surrendering. The fact that Fiora is literally feeding doesn't help the cause at all. But we are coming in. Boom. I'm having some fun. He's literally just running into him and giving him the kills. She's literally just feeding. She just doesn't care, she's just running in, doing damage and feeding. But actually doing something to the point where she can do some damage to him. I will stand here and take all this damage. Ackley is...
Excuse me, but which king?
Gonna be a threat. Fish. She's not caring, she's just literally running in and doing all this. Wow. Okie dokie. Don't know what to say there, I really don't. I mean, we did quite well, I was hoping for that. They did come up quite fast. Ulti is up, I'm not. They are going to try and go for the Baron at this point, so you want to kind of like, play it around. Don't let Diana die, straight onto Twitch. Better idea, don't leave Fiora out on her own. I don't get how this Fiora works either, like as a champion itself, how does it work? Can I?
One people here is 50 galleons.
How does this work? So I was thinking, like, if they was gonna try and do that, could I take... Could I do my ultimate on top of? I'll keep putting that there. Not in the slightest am I quitting. They're going to be regrouping to clear out that wave. They might actually get a tower dead though. Yep, they dropped the tower. Nice. All as five. Like that means like we need everyone to do just one big push and probably do a kill on it.
Apparently I'm some sort of big deal.
Let me see.
This fight for the ages.
Jin's about to die.
It's the only place I've been.
Jin's definitely about to try and suicide into this. Fiora's going down there. Oh, we need to stay in the team. Oh, she went pop. She got the Elder Drake, but...
Please get the pigeons out of my head.
Ackley Did she just literally do that? Or did he do that? How the feck? Stop, pause, don't say that. How in the world did our whole team just die other than Jin? I mean, I was trying to follow Fiora and help her because Fiora is the better one to help at the minute, because even though she's a pain, she does a lot of damage. Seriously, Jin, just back off. Just back off. I thought I could have got there faster than I did. Obviously, I couldn't. So, yeah, that was my slight mistake. I really did think I could have got there faster. I don't get how I didn't. Like, Jin, Twitch must have been fighting that on his own for a while. You know, I'm not sure if all of them got it, but they definitely did get a Baron. I mean, he must have been fighting it for a while though, he really must have. See, Fiora's gonna end up dead, because they're all going for her, they always do. Fiora will be dead in a second. Nope. See, all she keeps doing is trying to quit. And to be honest with you, I don't quit in rank because I don't see the point in it. It's just stupid. The matches can go either way. I've been in matches where I've quit and it's like, hang on, no, we could have pushed that and won that. With the outcomes that was happening, I just got to the point where it was getting, I got the annoyed, ragey thing where it was like, I just want to quit, and you know, and that was how it happened, and that's how you do that type of stuff. But I didn't go back at that point. Come on. Yep, you dead. Come on, we've got this one. We've got her. Don't worry about it. I've got this too. Bye bye to you. I'm going straight for this in here. Definitely going for the in here. Oh, look at that. Enable one. I'm in a bad eye there. You know what? They can do it. I should have just went back. Oh, that was a dumb move. I should have just went back. Really, really dumb move by me. I have done a lot of mistakes in this match, and I can, like I say, I do watch over the matches before I jump into another match, and I see what mistakes I've done. And I try to learn from my own mistakes. This is why I also watch, like, I watch YouTube videos myself, so I'll try and watch on a character that I use frequently. I'll try and learn like what I've done wrong and how other people play in higher tiers. So I do a lot of stuff to try and improve myself, and I know I make a lot of mistakes. I'm trying to improve on my own mistakes. there is certain things, but again, I did jump straight into using a Galio for the first time, and I like doing 9 kills, 25 assists, there is 13 deaths to throw in there, but then you look at the team and you've got Jax with 18, Diana with 14, Fiora with 17. By 13 don't look that bad when you've got the jungle alone with 18, you know, it's just,
they just don't make doorways big enough.
It's one of them things that you don't really see as less deaths is something I really do need to like angle on. Did you just literally try stun me under the tower? The thing I like about this Galio as well is his wave clear is actually quite cool. He can wave clear quite fast.
Powerful magic around here.
What can I get? Go, go, go! No. I literally gave myself a death just to get you out of there, so you better run. Oh, you didn't run. What a melon. Why did you not run? Seriously, why did you not run? You were supposed to have ran. That was the poorest shit you've ever seen. Not bad last two shots, but yeah. Let's see. We could probably get rid of that. Possibly push a little bit more damage, but as well as this, do that. It's probably game over at this point anyway. I'd say mute all is definitely one of the best things to do when you're out in these types of leagues. Destroy it. The Acolyte to me as well, she's one of them annoying champions that you just don't want to be around because they're annoying enough to know that she'll just, she's one of them annoyingly overpowered wimpy champions where they can just go drop down, I'm hidden, what do I do, wait for it, health's gone low, bang, your kill is mine, you know, and she's a very, very good character. Very, very good character. She's just very wimpy. Now, their Leona, a 40 assist, you can't go wrong. Now, annoying, very, very annoying player. Don't want to be playing with her. So, thanks, LOL is a name I'll be looking out for again at a later date. If I see it, I will be turning around and saying, look, I'm sorry, but this is a really, really highly toxic player and I don't want to play alongside her or something like that. I won't ditch out of a game because I'll lose league points. I've got 9 league points in bronze 5, so I'm not really bothered about that. But it's like this, you were all and in like LOL and you know all these, to me that's not what you want in a game. You don't come into a game to do all that. Either way, I don't know why I'm playing with Bree 5. Maybe because you flame, you're very toxic, and you're not actually as good as you think you are. He's just throwing that out there. Anyone can take a Fiora and do 20 kills. She's not that hard of a champion. You take other champions and do that, then yeah. But yeah, that's enough of my rant, my rage. That's all of that's gone. Galio in the breakdown was a good champion. Do like him. Will be playing him again a few more times. More likely as a support as well. So yeah, that's going to be happening. Hopefully we can get used to him, get better with him, get a decent skin on him. Because I like having a good skin on the character every now and again. But with all that being said, thank you all for watching. It's been a pleasure recording this for you. I apologize for all the rage, but it's going to happen. I've been Fiora. Stay amazing. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button, and I shall see you next time.